Hello students of class 8. This is our second revisional chapter. The name of the chapter is Pressure Belts and Wind. Before starting, I am telling again the syllabus for your second unit test. Pressure Belts and Wind, Cloud and Rain, Neighboring Countries and Oceania. The chapter Oceania also contain the map pointing that you have to practice. So let's revise the chapter Pressure Belts and Winds again. First, page 67. What is atmosphere? The layer of air that surrounds the earth is called atmosphere. What is atmospheric pressure or air pressure? Air is a combination of different gases and it exerts pressure, that is called air pressure. Then there is high pressure and low pressure. The pressure which is higher than the surrounding is called high pressure, and the pressure which is lower than the surrounding is called the low pressure. The normal pressure at sea level is 1013.2 millibar. This is the normal pressure at sea level, 1013.2 millibars. Okay, so this is from the first page. The why we feel breathlessness or why we feel difficulty when we travel in the high mountainous region, because of the absence of air in the higher atmosphere. Okay, next you go to the next page, page 68. In page 68 you will get what the different types of pressure belt. There are how many pressure belts? There are 7 pressure belts in the earth. The most important are the 7 pressure belts are equatorial low pressure belt, 2 subtropical high pressure belt, 2 subpolar low pressure belt and 2 polar high pressure belt. So first is the equatorial low pressure belt. Equatorial low pressure belt extends from 0 to 5 degree north and south. What are the reasons for the formation of low pressure in the equatorial region? High temperature, rotational force of the earth and presence of water masses. Okay, this equatorial low pressure belt is also known as doldrum. Why are they are called doldrum or belt of calm? Because of the absence of any horizon, any movement. There is no vertical movement of the air. So it is the region remain calm. Next part is the subtropical high pressure belt. This pressure belt extends from 30 to 35 degree north and south. The most important part is in this belt is the horse latitude. This belt is called horse latitude. Why they are called horse latitude? Because in this belt there is absence of backing winds. So as there is an absence of backing winds, the ships face problem. So to avoid this weight of the ship, the sailors throw some of their horses while traveling through this latitude. They throw some of their horses so that the ship can be lightened to reduce the weight of the ship. So this belt is called horse latitude. So, okay. Next, in this part, what is air current and what is wind? The vertical movement is called air current and the horizontal movement of air is called wind. Okay, this part only you will read. Next, what is pressure cell? Always the distribution is not regular. Sometimes it is broken into several concentric cell or circle known as pressure cell. Pressure cell, when the pressure belts are divided into concentric circles like this. It is divided into concentric circles. Next is isobar. What is isobar? The imaginary line drawn on the map joining the places having equal pressure. The places experiencing equal pressure can be joined by an imaginary line known as isobar. Okay, next there is Ferrell's law, very important. Ferrell's law, it is a law stated by W. Ferrell. Professor W. Ferrell, he states that all the freely moving wind object like pressure, wind, ocean current will deflect right in the northern hemisphere and left in the southern hemisphere because of Earth's rotation. This is called Ferrell's law, which was formulated by famous scientist Professor W. Ferrell. Where is Coriolis force? Is maximum, it is maximum at pole, and minimum, it is zero at the equator. Very important. Next part is the Bayes-Ballot law. This is also an important law, which all states that if you are in the northern hemisphere and if I am standing facing the direction of the wind, high pressure will be formed in my right and low pressure in my left, and just reverse happens in case of in southern hemisphere. So this is called the Bayes-Ballot law. These two laws are very important, Farrell's law and Bayes-Ballot law. Okay, whatever telling, only read this part. Okay, next part is the different types of wind. There are planetary winds, periodic winds, local winds, and sudden winds. Planetary winds are those winds that move in same direction throughout the year. Planetary winds are of three types: trade wind, westerlies, and polar winds. Trade winds, the name trade winds give by the traders, as these winds, as this path of trade wind is very suitable for trading purpose, it is also called trade wind. The two trade wind, northeast and southeast trade wind, meet each other at equatorial low pressure belt, so they are also known as ITCZ or intertropical convergence zone. This belt is called ITCZ or intertropical convergence zone. The two trade wind, northeast and southeast trade wind, converge. Okay, the velocity of trade wind is maximum in the northern, minimum in the northern hemisphere, and maximum in the southern hemisphere. In the northern hemisphere, there are huge landmasses where the wind gets obstructed. But in the southern hemisphere, there are wide open oceans, so the wind blows with full velocity and speed. Next is the westerlies. The wind that blows from west is called westerlies. Westerlies are also become very much furious in the southern hemisphere because of the presence of wide open ocean. The westerlies are named differently in different latitudes in north southern hemisphere. At 40 degrees south, it is called roaring 40s. At 50 degrees south, it is called furious 50s. At 60 degrees south, it is called screaming 60s. As the westerlies blows in the southern hemisphere, it makes tremendous sound. So these three names are given in the three different latitudes. Next, westerlies. In the western margin of the continent, deserts are formed in the western margin of the continent. Why? Because when the westerlies blows, they blows offshore, that is from land to sea. So the wind is dry, so the air is dry, there is no moisture, no rainfall in the western margin of the continents. So large deserts like Sahara, Atacama, Kalahari, etc. formed in the western margin of the continent. Okay. Now next part is the periodical wind. The wind that blows in particular period is called periodical wind. Periodical winds are of three types: sea breeze, land breeze, and monsoon wind. What is sea breeze? Sea breeze, the wind that blows from sea to land, cool air blows from sea to land during daytime is called sea breeze. Just opposite is land breeze, that is during night, the wind from land to sea, the wind blows is called land breeze. And monsoon winds are the broader version of land breeze and sea breeze. The word monsoon is derived from the Arabic word mosin, meaning season. Monsoon winds are seasonal winds that gives rainfall. Next is the local wind. Local winds are those winds that blows in a particular locality because of local relief differences, climatic differences. There are two types of local wind: warm local wind, cold local wind. Some important names are Loo, Fawn, Chinook, Pampero, etc. They are warm local wind, and Mistral, Bora, Harmattan, they are cold local wind. Now, Loo is a local wind of northern India. Kalbaishakhi, it is in West Bengal. Then the other name of Chinook is snow eater, because it decreases the temperature, melts the, as it is a warm wind, it melts the ice, so it is called snow eater. And Harmattan is called doctor wind, and it reduces the temperature, so they are called doctor wind. Next, sudden wind. This is almost the last part, the sudden wind. The sudden winds are those winds that come all of a sudden without any prior notification. Sudden winds comes suddenly. We cannot predict that when they will come. Sudden winds are of two types: cyclone and anticyclone. Cyclones are the winds with low pressure center, and the winds comes from outside towards the center. It is anti-clockwise in northern hemisphere and clockwise in southern hemisphere. And anti-cyclones are high pressure in center, low pressure outside. And the wind blows clockwise in northern hemisphere, anti-clockwise in southern hemisphere. All the question answers already given with the first video. This is a revisional video and go through the chapter and the part done in the class. Only the marked portion you should read thoroughly. And the word cyclone and anticyclone, it is named by Henry Predicton and anticyclone by Francis Gilton. So the two, these are the revisional chapter of this part, the pressure belts and wind. Read the part thoroughly, whatever done in the class, and marked portion read properly. Thank you, class.